I thought you told me you was there by yourself and you was gonna ride out these 50 years with me, girl. You're breaking my heart, girl.
Hey, by any chance, did you put that money order in the mail for me so I could order some commissary? What's going on, everybody? Welcome to After Prison Show, and in this video, we're going to be talking about some prison commissary necessity items. Things that you absolutely must have immediately upon getting to prison. And you know, one thing that you may not know about leaving jail and going to prison, at least here in the state of Virginia, and I'm pretty sure this applies to many other states as well. But when you get packed up and leave to go from jail to prison, in a lot of cases, you're not allowed to take much of anything with you at all. Especially when it comes to commissary items. In most cases, when you get transferred from jail to prison, you're essentially gonna have to start all over. There's also the high possibility that when you get to prison, you're gonna need a few things different or maybe weren't available to you while you were in the jail. So it's with all of that and again that in this video, I'm gonna be telling you about some prison commissary items that you absolutely must have. Most everybody in prison has very little, if any, money at all. And in most cases, the money that prisoners do have either comes from some sort of a prison job that I can guarantee you ain't paying them very much at all, or either from loved ones who are sending them money in every time they get on the phone like, "Hey, who that in the back where I can hear him right now? I don't want to get all loud and let these dudes know I'm arguing on the phone, but I swear I hear another man in the back. But hey, who is that right there? Let me talk to him. Is that Jody? Who over there with you, baby? I thought you told me you was there by yourself and you was gonna ride out these 50 years with me, girl. Hey, you're breaking my heart, girl." Hey, by any chance, did you put that money order in the mail for me so I could order some commissary?
You know, real quick, I was just thinking about it, like how I remember guys would tell me these crazy stories. They would call home telling their loved ones, whether it was their mom or their dad or their girlfriend, their sister, their brother, anybody who would pick up that phone for them. But these crazy stories, some of these guys would tell their loved ones just in an effort to try to get money sent in. And in most cases, these crazy stories were concocted because they were dealing with some sort of addiction that they were getting heavily in debt behind. "Hey, mom, thank God you picked up. Look, I'm gonna need you to send me like $400. I swear I'm having a problem with these dudes in here right now, mom. If you love me, you're going to send me $400. I need it tomorrow, mom. Can you hurry up in Western Union? Me that money. I need that money, mom. Thank you so much. Thank you. Okay, I love you too. Goodbye." "She said she's sending me the money. Hey, did Duke come back from visitation yet?" "Oh my God, mom, you're still on the phone."
Sorry about that. I got completely off track. But the original point that I was trying to make is that most guys in prison are on a very fixed income. They only have a certain amount of money, if any money at all, that they can use to buy commissary with. And you know, I've been in that exact situation many, many times, too many damn times, in fact, many times throughout my life, where you only have about $25 that you can spend every week, maybe every 2 weeks. You've only got a very small amount of money to your name and also on your books that you can use to go to the store with. And because of that, you're gonna have to do some very strategic budgeting, and a lot of times you're gonna have to go without just in an effort to be able to get what you need. And with all of that strategic and thrifty spending that you're gonna be forced to do while in prison, the worst of this is likely to occur just first getting there. Because there's going to be things that you absolutely need to buy. And some of these things you only have to buy like one time, and others you might have to buy them every month or every couple of months. And some of these absolute necessity items, they're not cheap at all. And they're definitely going to be putting a hurting on your little prison pocket. Oh, and by the way, real quick, if anybody ever asks you anything about a prison pocket while you're in prison, you're best to just hit them in the face right then and there.
"Hey, what's going on with you, man? I couldn't help but to notice you're the new guy in here. You're the fish, aren't you? This is your first time being in prison? Hey, has anybody told you anything about a prison pocket? Something that you could hold?"
"Your pocket? You want me to hold your pocket? I ain't holding nothing."
Bang, 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 bang.
So yeah, even though some of these items are most certainly going to be putting a hurting on your pocket because you're going to have to spend a little bit to be able to get these things, and a lot of times just to be able to get these items, you're going to have to go without the zoom zooms and wham whams, no ramen noodle soup, sodas, chips, crackers, or honey buns. You're going to have to do you some thrifty spending and get these things that you need first. Because if anybody sees you coming back from commissary that very first time when you're just getting to prison and you don't have these necessity items and instead you've got you a bunch of honey buns, chips, and sodas, oh, they're coming to take everything from you. And in fact, you're going to make it very easy for them. Because one of the absolute first things that you need from commissary when you get to prison
is a lock.
Oh, I knew you was gonna say lock, Joe. I just knew you was gonna say we need us a lock. That way we can put that in a sock and we can be ready for whatever.
Hey, Joe, you a straight soldier, Joe. I knew you were trained to go. Talking about we gotta get us a lock first. In most cases, no. Getting a lock for a weapon immediately upon getting a prison is not why you need a lock. The reason you need a lock is because you're gonna have lockers. And inside those lockers, you're potentially gonna have stuff. If you're so lucky to have some stuff in those lockers, meaning that somebody in the free world loves you, or maybe you got you a prison job that's gonna pay you enough to keep you some stuff in that locker, you're gonna wanna keep that stuff safe. And the number one way that you can do that is by buying a lock from commissary as soon as you get to prison. But then again, I'm sure there are some cases where guys get to prison and immediately have problems. They're probably getting beat up from the moment that they step off of the bus. So potentially they're gonna go ahead and buy a lock so they can try to handle some business. And by handling business, I ain't talking about putting that lock inside of a sock and using that against nobody. I'm talking about taking that lock, opening up that locker, putting themselves inside of that locker, and then locking that lock so nobody can mess with them anymore. Because if they're getting beat up from the moment they're getting off the bus, they ain't gonna be no good with a lock inside of a sock neither.
Hey, y'all better stay away from me, man. I got this lock inside of a
sock. I'm trying to tell you, some guys, they really have a tough time in prison. But with the fact that a lock is so important to have, getting one is definitely going to set you back a little bit, especially if you're on one of them fixed incomes like we were first talking about. And let's say you've only got about $25 a week that you can spend, or maybe every 2 weeks. Well, a lock could cost you anywhere from about $8 to $15. So that lock could very easily wipe out about half of that money you've got to spend. Now, right along with that lock purchase, there better be some other things on that bubble sheet as well. And these might actually be the most important items that you're going to need to have in prison. And these are your hygiene items. Your soaps, your deodorants, your toothbrush, your toothpaste, at the absolute very least. And the reason these are probably just as important, if not more important, than that lock, it's not just for the simple fact that you can keep yourself clean with these items. It's also just as important that wherever you're housed inside of the prison, whether in a housing unit, cell block, sharing a cell with somebody, or being bunked with or around whoever, them folks that you're living in close quarters with are gonna wanna know that you know what you need to do, go buy those hygiene items, and that you also use them, keeping yourself properly clean. Because one thing don't nobody ever want to be surrounded by in prison is a dirty, nasty motherfucker. You could be living in close quarters with 100+ people. So with that, there is already going to be so many nasty, disgusting smells. And nobody wants to be sharing any type of prison space with somebody who's contributing to them smells because they don't have good hygiene. Hey, new guy, I see you just came back from the store. I know you got you a toothbrush, toothpaste, deodorant, and some soap, didn't you?
Nah, I ain't have no money for that. I only had $25 I could spend. All I bought was some ramen noodle soup, some candy bars, sodas, a couple of honey buns. I don't need no soap. What I need some soap for? I can wash off with a honey bun.
Hey, do me a favor. Go ahead, pack up all your stuff, take it up to the booth, knock on the window, and tell the guard you ain't safe in here. You got to go. You ain't buy no soap, man! You have got to practice good hygiene while in prison, because if you don't, you're guaranteed to have problems. And you know, some guys, what they'll do immediately upon getting to prison, they'll go ahead and buy that lock, and then they'll go ahead and stockpile hygiene. They'll buy 10 bars of soap, a couple of deodorants, a couple boxes of toothpaste, a couple of toothbrushes, and they're trying to make sure they're good to go and they ain't gotta buy hygiene products again for like the first 6 months to a year. Now, right along with these hygiene products, there's one other thing I need to throw in with this, and that is razors. You know, it's the craziest damn thing to think about, but in a lot of prisons, they actually sell the prisoners razor blades so they can shave. Because in a lot of prisons, they got what's called grooming compliance. Meaning that you gotta keep your fingernails cut and walk around that place looking like a butt ball baby face. But yeah, right along with those hygiene items, you're most certainly gonna have to buy you a couple of razors. Because one thing about it, if you don't buy no razors and you ain't got nothing to shave with, and them guards come around doing a grooming compliance check, which they will often do, they do it like 3 times a week, and they see that your face ain't shaved, you run the risk of getting a charge. And if it's your first charge, let me tell you one thing that they most certainly can and oftentimes will do. They will actually give you a fine in prison. They will give you a charge and give you a fine. And guess where they're gonna get the money for that fine from? They're gonna take it right out of your old Zoom Zooms and Wham Whams account.
Hey man, this ain't right, man. I just got me a $15 fine because I wasn't in grooming compliance.
You know, that's pretty damn crazy, and I'm sorry to hear that. But you know, a razor on commissary is only 30 cents. So had you spent that 30 cents on a razor instead of a ramen noodle soup, you wouldn't be paying a $15 fine.
We in prison, you gotta follow the rules, man.
And that's a little funny to me, especially considering the fact for the first 4 years while I was in prison, I ain't follow any rules at all. In fact, I made my own damn rules. But I got in a lot of trouble for that, and I lost a lot of good time. And you know what? After those first 4 years of bucking and doing what I wanted to do, I was following the rules, at least for the most part. The next prison commissary necessity items are going to be your stationery supplies. Your paper, your pens, your stamps, your envelopes. Now, these items are only going to be important to those who have loved ones out in the free world. And most everybody who is locked up, they do got one form or fashion of some type of loved ones out there. In most cases, it's going to be a girlfriend or a girlfriend that you don't even know really is an ex-girlfriend now because she done moved on since you got locked up. But having these stationery items are going to give you one of the very few senses of security that you have to be able to maintain contact with whoever you have out there in the free world.
Keep it together. We gotta write this letter. We gotta find out what's going on.
Dear Sally, it's been 14 and a half years and 13 days since I've heard from you. I'd like to believe that we are still together, considering I've never received a letter telling me otherwise. You know I love you. Sally, I really hope that you haven't forgotten about me and potentially moved on with one Jody or another. Hell, to be completely honest with you, you've probably moved on with about 15 Jodys in the last 14 and a half years and 13 days. I have been keeping track of how long it's been, Sally, not only because I still love you, but because when I do come home, I'm going to find you, and I'll probably go looking for all 15 of those Jodys as well. I also hope that the dog's okay and that you didn't get rid of him just like you've probably gotten rid of me. And I'll be looking forward to seeing you in 13 years, 4 months, 7 days, and 24 hours. I love you, Sally, and I hope that you still love me.
You're gonna be needing you some pen, paper, stamps, and envelopes while locked up. And hell, even if you don't have anybody to write to in the world and you feel completely gone and forgotten, you know, having a pen and a piece of paper is a good way to write down your thoughts, to write down maybe some ideas that you might have, some things that might be beneficial to you when you get out.
Yeah, man, that game was crazy last night, man. You see the way he just banged on that dude? Man, that game was crazy. Came right down. Hey, hold on. I gotta go write down this business idea. I just had me a $1 billion business idea.
Daddy do right. Daycare. I'm gonna start me a daycare service when I...
Hey, man, they been trying to copy my ideas, man. You gotta come up with your own ideas. You got a pen and a piece of paper, too. I'm going home and start me a daycare service.
These next prison commissary essentials are pretty important as well. And these are gonna be your prison household goods. Your cup, spoon, and bowl. Three things that you can buy off of commissary and three things that you're probably going to need. Because hopefully at some point you will be able to order some Zoom Zooms and Wham Whams, some ramen noodle soups, some coffee, things that you're gonna need that cup, bowl, and spoon for. And you know, there's a lot of guys in prison who aren't even fortunate enough to be able to make commissary every week or even every couple of weeks. They don't have any ramen noodle soups. They ain't got no coffee. They can't afford these things. Yet, you'll still oftentimes see that these guys, they've got a cup, bowl, and a spoon. And there's a good reason for that as well. Let's use Coffee Man, for example. This was a guy who never was able to go to the store. This guy never had any money sent into him at all. And he also had like one of the worst paying prison jobs that there was. This guy worked in the kitchen and was making like 17 cents an hour, which equated to about $20 a month. And $20 a month ain't gonna be doing you much of any good in prison. This guy would buy him one bar of soap and like 4 bags of coffee. They didn't call him Coffee Man for no reason after all. But you know, there are cases, and I mean, I used to do this for Coffee Man as well, where other more fortunate prisoners who are able to go to the store will oftentimes look out for some of these less fortunate guys, maybe tossing them a soup. Hey, Coffee Man, here's a soup, man. You look like you ain't ate in a week. You need to stop trading all your trays for cups of coffee. Or maybe giving them just that, you know, a cup of coffee. But even if a prisoner isn't able to go to commissary at all or all that often, every prisoner is trying to have them a cup, a bowl, and a spoon. Because even if you're not making commissary, you never know when that can come in handy and somebody actually looks out for you doing some sort of like a prison good deed. There's one final thing that I want to mention on this list of prison absolute necessities. You know, there's so many things I could have included with this, but I'm just trying to give you an idea of the bare essentials. The things that you really, really need to get your hands on pretty much immediately upon getting to prison. And this last item I'm going to include, in my own personal opinion, I mean, this is an absolute must-have. You have got to order this immediately upon getting to prison. When you order that lock and you order that hygiene and you order that razor and you order them stationary supplies, you're best to go ahead and order you a couple of packs of Tylenol as well. Yes, on prison commissary, they do sell certain medicine type items. It's not going to be very much of anything. You might be able to get you some cough syrup. You might be able to get you some stool softener, maybe some Tums, but you will be able to get you some Tylenol. And in prison, you are most certainly going to need it. Not only is this good to have in case you get sick, you get a fever. I think Tylenol is good for a fever. Or maybe you got some aches and pains as well because you just got beat up. But you are also most certainly going to need that Tylenol because I can guarantee you you're going to be getting some headaches in prison. You know, prison in a lot of cases is like an insane asylum. You got nothing but a bunch of crazy, out of control people running around being loud pretty much 24/7. There could even be cases where they're screaming right in your ear as you're trying to go to sleep.
Hey, what y'all doing over there? Y'all trying to play some spades and some poker? What's going on? Let's get the poker table jumping! Let's get the poker table jumping!
It might not go down exactly like that, because if it does, you better jump off that rack, put your shoes on, and get to fighting immediately, because that is an absolute sign of disrespect. However, the point I am trying to make with all of this is, prison will oftentimes be a loud and obnoxious place. And there ain't nothing worse than being sick or having a headache and not being able to do anything about that in prison. You know, when you're sick and not feeling good, you're gonna be a weaker version of yourself. You ain't gonna be 100%. And that could put you in a pretty vulnerable situation if someone was trying to bring problems your way. Again, what I've mentioned here in this video, these are the absolute prison essential items that you must have immediately upon getting to prison. Some of these items you're probably only going to have to order one time, like the lock. And others, you're going to be ordering these things every once in a while. However, when you first get to prison, these are things that you need to have first before you go trying to spend some money on some ramen noodle soups, crackers, sodas, chips, and honey buns. Hey, look, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did so, please leave a like and a comment letting me know exactly what you thought about it. As always, until next time, enjoy life, the free world, never take a moment for granted, and make the most of every day. Peace!